During the American Civil War, the imposing mill at the corner of Main Street and Boonslick served as a temporary prison for Confederate sympathizers, while the rooftop provided a perfect lookout for Union troops. After the war, this building served many purposes, including a short period where it operated as a corn cob pipe factory. In fact, St. Charles is proud to claim the inventor of this iconic novelty, Wilson Doc Carr, as one of its own citizens. While St. Charles' history is filled with eccentric characters like Doc Carr, what you might not expect is that witches have been a facet of this town's lore for over half a century. In the 1960s, a myth began to spread recounting the tale of Molly Crenshaw, a supposed witch who lived in St. Charles County in the middle of the 19th century. After the local villagers blamed her for a disastrous crop failure, Molly met her end at the hands of an angry mob. Fearing that she would come back to life and seek revenge, the townsfolk chopped the witch into pieces and buried the body parts in separate graves scattered throughout the countryside. Allegedly, the graves inch closer and closer together with each passing year. While Molly Crenshaw did exist, she wasn't a witch in the 1800s who was killed by an unruly mob, but rather a quiet spinster and schoolteacher who died after ingesting a bottle of carbolic acid in 1913. But that fact hasn't stopped generations of teenagers who to this day can still be found on moonless nights searching for the lost graves of St. Charles's most famous sorceress. While the Molly Crenshaw myth is more based in urban legend, the current location you're in has a witchcraft connection grounded in reality. The structure nearby at 903 South Main that currently houses Magpie's Cafe has long been known by some as the Witch's House, and for good reason. This building was once occupied by a school of witchcraft that was founded in 1968. Turn your attention to the upper floor window. This third floor played host to coven meetings into the 1970s, where it became the first federally recognized Wiccan church in 1972. The founders of the school, Gavin and Yvonne Frost, eventually traded the Little Hills of St. Charles for the Hollywood Hills of Los Angeles, where in addition to writing several books about witchcraft, they appeared on The Phil Donahue Show.